You can get great photos, great videos off of any type of gear. Each camera company out there, like Nikon, Sony, Canon, Olympus, everyone comes out with their flagship models. Their best, the greatest, you can't get any better. And like I said, you can get great images off of any setup. It's not up to the equipment to get the photos, it's up to you. But what if we use the best, the greatest, the highest echelon of equipment that we can possibly use? Well, that is what we're going to talk about today. So what's up, guys? This big bag right here is the subject of conversation today. Inside, we have the Canon 600mm f/4 number 3. Now, this isn't the mirrorless variant. This is what was designed from DSLRs, but I have used this lens on mirrorless cameras, which we're going to go pretty in-depth on today. Now, I almost shot this review and put this review out maybe a half a year ago, but I said, Tomas, no, don't do it. Use this lens for another 6 more months and really get used to it, really know the ins and outs so you can tell everyone, what are the pros, what are the cons? Is it really worth the extra bit of money to invest in a lens like this? So I'm gonna tell you guys right off the bat, let's just get it over with. Is this lens worth the money? Well, it's kind of a complicated answer. If you are a professional wildlife photographer making money off of your wildlife images, then yes, buy this lens. Just stop watching this video. Try to make enough money to buy this lens, which is worth a small car. But if you are an amateur photographer, you are going to be happy to know that you can get results, amazing results, off of lenses and equipment that are much lower priced and stuff that you can buy for a significant fraction of the cost of this guy. So without further ado, here she is. Now, I just want to get this out of the way. I did not buy this lens. I don't have the money to buy this lens. Canon supports the projects that I do, so they were nice enough to loan me this lens to use as long as I'm just doing projects. So thank you very much, Canon. And for you guys who are watching this with an eyebrow raised going, is Tomas going to be unbiased? You're gonna have to take my word for it that I'm going to be as little biased as I possibly can. I'll put it out there, whether you're shooting with a Nikon 600mm f/4 or a Sony 600mm f/4, you're going to be getting amazing results. I prefer Canon for my own reasons. I like Canon's atmosphere, I like Canon's ecosystem. I like all of their lenses, I love all of their bodies. So I chose Canon. So now that we got those biases out of the way, let's just go right into it. This is how she looks like packed up. This is an enormous lens, but it's actually pretty light. This lens came out only a year and a half ago. I'll put up the, let's just get all of the extraneous specs out of the way. This lens is considered the best for wildlife and bird photography because it sits in that sweet spot. Your image is going to be framed really, really close to that bird, that wildlife. Maybe you're photographing a sport and you're very, very far away and you need something like this. You know what? We're not even going to put the lens hood on because we need to save space. But here she is. This lens is extremely, extremely light. That's one of the things I noticed about it first, and that is its pro number one. This lens is insanely light. And this made it so I can actually go handheld with this lens. I was just astounded by how good this lens was. And on top of that, when I guess this is gonna just mix with number two that I was gonna say, is the image stabilization is just insane. I was able to shoot handheld video with this lens. Now, was it ideal? No, I still had to use warp stabilizer and maybe do a lot of stuff in post-production, but I was able to do it and that was pretty cool. And especially when I was pairing this lens with a mirrorless body like the Canon R5, I actually was shooting handheld without the need of warp stabilizer or any editing software to get super cool footage that was quite frankly just, I don't even have any words. It's just magical. I'll just put it that way. It's just magical. Now, could you be getting that footage with another lens? Yes, like the Canon 100-400 or the Canon 100-500, both have great image stabilization to keep up with your mirrorless camera. Now, if you're shooting on a DSLR, that's when you're going to be needing a tripod, most likely is with video. The biggest pro to using these big primes is, you guessed it, the image quality. The sharpness you're going to get is basically better than any other piece of equipment you will use out there. Is it astronomically better than something like a variable focal length lens? No, it's not like, oh my God, it's just so much better, you know, it's so much better in every way. No, it's not astronomically better. Is it better? Yes. There's a couple other things that really put it ahead of variable length lenses. Like the fact that this lens is F4 means I can shoot later in the day. And when I pair this lens up with a Canon R5 or a Canon R6, I am able to keep on shooting well into the evening, very, very late into the evening, and still get some really, really cool shots. Real world example. Some of you may have seen my film, Sentinels of the Boreal. There I had to go out to Minnesota in sub-zero temperatures to basically video and photograph these beautiful great gray owls. Now, not only was this lens able to handle the snow and the crazy conditions that we were met with, but I was also able to do handheld video, which was insane, especially when I paired it with, again, the Canon R5, which I'm actually shooting now with this review. The footage I got was nothing short of stunning. I used this lens for the interviews, for a lot of the wildlife stuff, and it showed me, wow, the amazingness of technology and how technology can really push your limits to what you're able to obtain, if that makes any sense. I don't know if I really made any sense there, but you get the point. I got some really cool results from that. This one shot of this great gray owl with the snow shooting at F4, I was able to totally isolate the great gray owl from the background, and man, the image just looks so, so nice. And again, nothing short of magical. Here's a quick disadvantage though. Now that we're on the topic of this Minnesota trip, I was shooting this great gray owl, and this great gray owl kept flying in closer and closer and closer. Now this owl in particular was one of the great gray owls that had been pushed down from the north into this region in Minnesota, and it wasn't very scared of humans, so it was hunting very, very close to us. And at one point, it grabbed a vole very close to me. Not crazy close, but close enough where I had a hard time finding it with this lens because I'm already at 600 millimeters. I would have killed to be using my 100 to 400 millimeter so I can quickly zoom out and zoom back in and find that bird again. How does this lens handle the weather? Like I said before, this lens was able to handle those sub-zero temperatures, no problem. It was able to handle snow. I've put it in very wet snow, very dry snow, and even sopping wet, this lens was able to handle. Now, like I said, don't drop this lens in a vat of acid and expect it to be fine. You're gonna be having a huge price tag on your head if you do that. But what I'm saying is, Canon is telling the truth when they say that, yes, this lens is amazing when it comes to weather sealing. Now again, this lens was very hand holdable. I had no problem with that. So then we're gonna go into the ergonomics. The ergonomics of this lens are also really good. The way Canon designs their gear, and quite frankly, the way they design all of their gear, whether it's telephotos or smaller lenses, is very ideal. It makes it easy for me to memorize the different buttons, the different controls. So it's like an extension of my body, if that makes any sense. My creative mind isn't thinking about, oh my God, where's this button? It's natural, my hands go right to it, and that's the way I work. It works really well, and Canon does a great job with that. Now, there's a couple cool things with this lens that some of the stuff that I use and some of the stuff that I didn't necessarily use. The cool parts about it is, one, it has tons of little cool little features, like there are three panning modes, which are the same, you know, set of modes that are on their other telephoto lenses. They have this huge focal ring. So if you're shooting exclusively video and you need to be using a focal ring, it's huge. You're not gonna miss it trying to find it when something crazy happens. They have all these little buttons right here that basically allow you to program the lens and allows you to set it to certain parameters to make ease of shooting better. I did not use all these programmable features because I don't really have any need for it, but if you're someone who likes having that ease of use, that's something that you're gonna be liking, especially with this little programmable ring. Something I, again, didn't use, but something that's out there just so you know. If you're wondering, oh my God, the filter is gonna be crazy expensive. No, you don't put any filters on the front of this lens. On the front, this lens already has the anti-moisture type coating. The filter is actually down here. Check that out. So you can put different filters on depending on your situation. So, this is the part that a lot of you have probably been waiting for and something that I talked about in the very beginning. Comparing this lens to the Canon 100 to 400, is this lens worth the upgrade? Depends on you. If you're a pro, if you're making money off of wildlife stuff, if you are working on films with, I don't know, Smithsonian, PBS Nature, National Geographic, stuff like that, then yeah, you probably wanna look into investing in a lens like this because it is something that is just the industry standard and it's gonna push your images just to that next mark of like super pro results. Can you get pro results with other lenses like the 100 to 400, the 100 to 500, Tamron lenses, Sigma lenses? Of course you can, it's all about the photographer. And quite frankly, although the gear makes it easier for us, it doesn't negate the fact that it's really up to the experience of the photographer. I've seen some insane images with gear that only costs, you know, under $1,000, which in wildlife photography, that's pretty amazing. That's because the photographer gets to know the wildlife. They know how the wildlife reacts. They know the behaviors. So they're able to put themselves in situations where it makes them easier. That didn't make any sense. It makes it easier for you to get amazing shots. You're not gonna buy this lens, walk out in the woods, and all of a sudden be taking just amazing images. That never happens. But if you're already someone who's like that, who knows the wildlife behavior, who has been shooting with a variable focal length lens, and who does professional stuff, or quite frankly, you just have the money laying around, then by all means, invest in this. It's gonna be like a car, so make sure you get that extra insurance. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you liked all of the content that I'm sharing. If you like this video, like and subscribe. That is very appreciated to me. Also be sure to check out my sponsors, Milford Photo. I just love great people down there. You know where your money's going. It's a local brick and mortar store. And best of all, it's an official Canon, Nikon, Olympus, Tamron, Sigma, you name it, distributor. So when you buy your gear there, you're getting the warranties. You're getting all the cool stuff that goes along with buying the lens directly from the source. So anyway, if you are someone who wants to get a lens, whether it's one of these or whether it's, you know, a Tamron 18 to 400 millimeter, go there and get your stuff because guess what? You're supporting local business, which in this time is very, very important. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe. And as usual, have fun out there and get some good photos. Let's have some fun. Peace.